I'm Bryan Cranston. I just won the Olivier for best actor in a play.
In a play. How does it feel when you say it out loud?
In walking through storm.
It is.
It is.
Thank you very much.
Like storm.
It is stunning. The best way I can explain it is that if anyone's ever had a surprise party thrown for them, there is a multitude of emotions that you go through. You first go through shock, then you go through a little embarrassment, and then you go through glee because you see all the faces of the people you love. So you're going through so many things so quickly. That's about as closest that it feels like for those who are not in my position and been so fortunate.
Have you thought about where it's going to sit in your awards? Are you at the point of having to have like a cabinet especially for your awards?
No. I'm going to stare at it for the longest time. Just keep staring at it, and I don't know where it's going to go right now, but I'm just overjoyed that I got this award.
Does it feel like the best standing ovation ever?
Yes, and you know what? What's great is that in Britain, there is no obligatory standing ovation, and for personally, I love that. If you get one, you've earned it, and I think, aside from the Greeks, I think the British have the deepest theatrical roots. And because of that, it was one of the reasons I wanted to come here.
I just want to finally ask really quick just about the Time's Up badge and the fact you're wearing it. How important is it that award ceremonies like these actually, you know, keep the conversation around that going?
Well, that's the point, is that these awards will get attention. They'll see pictures with Time's Up so that it stays in the conversation. We have an opportunity right now to tear down the old ways, the old man, I'm in charge, pillars of misogyny have got to go. And it's dusty and dirty, and right now we're in the swill of it all, but we have an opportunity then to recreate a foundation that is based on mutual respect and grow that way so that my daughter doesn't have to face the same things that my wife had growing up in this business. And that means a lot, not just to my family, but all the people I know. And it's not just theater community. It's not just show business. This is true in academia, in business, and in politics. It has to change. It cannot be tolerated anymore.